Hello for everyone. Yesterday I changed some settings in my hassio setup and restarted it. And when I noticed that Home Assistant restart takes very long. And when I dig deeper into logs, I see that there is a problem with hassio, the Home Assistant recorder. Recorder is the database where Home Assistant stores all your sensors history, and when I search internet, so I find that it may be a problem with that database. Maybe some files or tables or some are corrupt, so because this problem occur, so I decided to experiment a little bit, and I have experience with MariaDB, so I decided that I will move the default Home Assistant database to MariaDB database. Today I'll show you how to do it. Okay, let's start. So, where is my Home Assistant setup? And the recorder is integration that writes your sensor data, sensor history to the file. So the file is in your config folder, and this is it, Home Assistant v2.db. Home Assistant, as mentioned in documentation, is saving data to Maria to SQLite database, so it don't need any configuration by default. But I saw in many forums that when your DB becomes bigger, the problems is starting. When you use, for example, Raspberry Pi for your Home Assistant, so and it is writing to SD card, in many cases. The database becomes corrupt because it reads and writes many times to SD card, and SD card may become corrupt. So it is better to move the DB from SD card to another external device or somewhere else. It will be better for your Raspberry and SD card. So as we see in recorder documentation, Home Assistant uses SQL Alchemy, which is a object relation mapper. So with it, you can use MySQL, MariaDB, PostgreSQL, and MS SQL Server to keep that data of your sensors. So if you have such problem, I can show you what the problem was. I don't save my logs to show you, but I find a similar. So when I restarted Home Assistant, it keeps very long, and I saw in the logs such lines that setup of recorder is taking over 2 seconds, but there wasn't no 10 seconds, it was minutes to restart, and then was this lines waiting on integrations to complete setup and many of it. So so now I will show you how to set up your we will use MariaDB in hassio. In hassio, first of all, I suggest you to go to configuration, no, supervisor, and snapshots, and make a, as you wish, a partial or full snapshot when you doing some bigger changes to your setups. I always suggest to make a full snapshot of your home assistant. I don't need a password, so I will create a snapshot. And when the snapshot will be created, we will move, not move, we leave the data in SQLite database. There is no sensitive data for me that I really need a lot, so I will leave data in that Home Assistant DB file, which is a SQLite file, and create a new database with MariaDB with hassio addon. So I have already have a MariaDB server on my other virtual server, but today I will show you how to create a new with help of supervisor in your Home Assistant setup, so you can connect to that database locally. Okay, let's go to supervisor and addon store, and here you need to search for MariaDB. MariaDB is a open source DB that is based on MySQL. So this is this the same. We can say it's the same. And here is a button. We click install, and install is starting. So we can look at documentation in this tab, and here is step by step all the instructions how we can connect our home assistant to this DB. So that's great. So now our snapshot is created, and addon is installed, MariaDB, and here we have some options. Start at boot, so we turn on watchdog. This will restart addon if it crashes, so we can turn it on. And auto update we can also turn on. Now we have to configure that addon. So in configuration, there is already a sample setup. Here will be created a database home assistant. Login will be created username home assistant with no password. Password null. I suggest you to use password, but for now I will leave it null. And rights, so username home assistant will have rights to database home assistant. And we can save. Here we will do no changes. And we can now start the addon. Here we have that failure to start addon, configuration validation failed, missing required option, password. So as we see, we can't start addon without password, so we will create one, and the password will be create MySQL assistant. This will be our password. Okay. Doesn't matter. So let's start Addon, and now we can see at logs what is going on. Refresh. No info now. Starting or not? Yes, it's starting. Not started yet. Let's see. Something going on. Okay. Info. Let's see. So successfully sent service information to Home Assistant. Okay, that's fine. So now we see that our MariaDB services started, and log shows that everything's fine. So now we need to add configuration to our config file. So this is it. We will be copying these lines and add it to configuration. We will open our configuration.yaml. And now we can put it here. Recorder, DB URL, tararam, password. So we need to add here password. What password we created? Let's see. MariaDB configuration. Just copy that password and put it here. Now I think everything is fine. Save and go to configuration. And server controls, check configuration. Configuration is valid, and we now restart our Home Assistant. Connection lost, reconnecting. Okay, let's see. Let's wait a little bit. Refresh the page. A little bit long. Home Assistant is started. Okay, let's see our logs. There are no issues. Okay, and now we will see history. That's very, very fast. Because the database is empty. Some sensors are written by now. So we will now collect more data and we will see how it will be working. I found on the internet feedback that with MariaDB Home Assistant works a lot faster and it's not stopping. So we will see, we collect more data and we'll see how it works. For now I see that is pretty good. Now we now see that we don't have any data before this time. So we installed the MariaDB server on our Home Assistant and now let's see. First time we rebooted it, so I think the Home Assistant needs some configs with MariaDB, and it can took a little bit longer, but now when this setup is complete, so I'll try to restart and let's see how long it takes. That's pretty fast. Last time I restarted when was that problem, so it took about 5 minutes or even more, 5 to 10 minutes to restart, so that's not acceptable. So now I think everything will be all right, and we will see when we collect more data how it works, what will be the performance of our server. So for now, thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel if you like this video, so press the thumbs up and don't forget to push the ring bell. Thank you. See you next time.